Most drug users don't plan on becoming addicts, but it happens all too often. Amy Lambert was stunned when it happened to her. Her story begins when she was 10. She grew up in a Christian home. Then, her parents divorced.
Tears are flowing down my face, and I didn't really understand what was going on, but all I knew was like my whole world was falling out from underneath me. And I went through just a whirlwind of emotions. There was a lot of anger, a lot of bitterness, and mainly, you know, the anger that I had in my heart, I mainly turned it towards God more than anyone else.
And her anger led to something more.
There was something on the inside of me that just became filled with rebellion. And I ran away from God as fast as I could run away from Him. And I wanted nothing to do with Christians or Christianity or church. I just wanted to be completely done with it.
She reached out to her friends, who had a ready solution.
I stayed at one of my friend's house, and we snuck out of the house. We met up with some boys out in a field in the middle of nowhere. And the first thing that I did was prescription drugs. They had pain pills. But I didn't know how to deal with all the emotions that I had inside. And so to do drugs was a way of escape. And by the time I was 13 years old, I was introduced to cocaine, marijuana, LSD, basically anything I could get my hands on. And it was a very quick progression.
She made it through high school, hiding her drug use from her parents. She moved out after graduation, and it wasn't long until she found even harder drugs.
My drug addiction escalated to a point where I would literally inject anywhere from 20 to 30 times a day. I mean, it was just such a dark, dark period in my life. The times where I lived in these crack motels, lived in abandoned buildings, lived, you know, sometimes out of my car, and would just, from daylight till dark, I was a needle junkie. I wasn't a party girl, I was a needle junkie. And I used in order to survive. And I remember, you know, looking at people that would be in the grocery store and looking at people on television, and I would so envy them because they were normal and they could function without having to wake up and put a needle in their arm.
Amy became a dealer, but it wasn't enough to support her habit, so she exchanged sex for drugs.
I think about being this young teenage girl who got involved with a drug dealer that was about 55 years old, and he basically became my sugar daddy. And there were moments in the darkness that only God knew about where I would cry. I would literally be in these moments where tears would be coming down my face, and I would be in the moment, and in my heart, I would be saying, God, rescue me from this. I do not want to live this lifestyle. I felt so degraded. I felt less than human, didn't deserve to be alive, but I would still, through my tears in the darkness, I would cry out to Him to save me.
One night, Amy tried to shoot up, and she completely missed the vein.
So my arm had swelled up the size of a grapefruit, and I had to call my mom on Monday morning and say, you need to come and pick me up, I'm in bad shape. They put me into the emergency room, the doctors ran tests on my body, and they brought my family into a room, and they said, of the stages of drug addiction, your daughter is at the last stage before death, and you guys need to prepare for her funeral.
Doctors operated on Amy's swollen arm, and she had to stay in the hospital for a week. While she was there, a group of women from a nearby church paid her a visit.
They just started ministering to me. And one lady in particular, who would later become my spiritual mother, she said, Amy, can I pray for you? And I said, yes, I had nothing left to lose. And when she began to pray, it was like God downloaded the message into her. Things that there's no way that she could have known about. She started to read my mail. And although I was 19 years old, I was street hard, I learned how to survive. It was like deep on the inside, I was just a broken and hurting little girl. And I'll never forget her asking me the question, and it was so powerful to me because I had that church background. And for years of my life, I thought I was okay because I knew in my head, John 3:16, I knew that Jesus died on the cross for my sins. But it was like God pulled the veil off of my eyes. And I realized in that moment, I am so lost. And she said, Amy, are you ready to surrender your life to Jesus Christ? And I called on the name of Jesus, and I meant it with all of my heart. And that was the beginning of my road towards transformation.
Amy committed to a one-year recovery program at Mercy Ministries in Louisiana.
Before I came into the program, I remember feeling like I didn't care whether I lived or died. I just had this guilt and this shame that just hung on me But I came to this realization, no, he really does have a hope and a future for my life.
5 years later, after working with several other ministries, Amy started her own recovery outreach, Hope Uprising. She speaks to thousands of young people every year who are hungry for the life-changing message of the gospel.
When I tell you right now, the greatest decision I ever made was to give Jesus everything, the good, the bad, and the ugly.
I remember many nights where I would be in these crack motels and I flip on the television and there's Christian television and it was like penetrating me. It was speaking directly to me. And one thing that I can say is that you are turning on this television broadcast for a reason and for a purpose. And if Jesus Christ can save my life and deliver me from multiple addictions, then he can do the same thing in your life.